Hello everyone, welcome to Achievers IAS classes. Let's begin our discussion on the current events of 13th January 2018. The first issue in news today is regarding the press conference held by the Supreme Court judges over their differences with the Chief Justice of India. The Hindu today is carrying various news articles as well as an editorial on the topic, which I'll club to give you a holistic picture on the issue. In the press conference, the four senior judges of the Supreme Court publicly accused the Chief Justice of India of selectively assigning cases to the judges of his choice without any rational basis, and the current practice of the CJI to assign cases to certain junior handpicked judges is against the time-tested convention of the court and might have far-reaching consequences to the nation. In this regard, the four senior judges failed to persuade the Chief Justice of India to take remedial measures. Therefore, overlooking the judicial protocol that sitting judges should not interact with the media, the four judges held a press conference which has been hailed by observers as both momentous as well as unfortunate, because the comments made by these judges cast shadows of integrity on the highest institution of the land, which will not easily subside for a long time to come. And some feel, even though there was ample evidence over the last few months that the highest court was in a state of ferment, the question could have been handled better internally rather than dragging into the open like this. So what triggered the current crisis is the allocation of judicial work, which is primarily based on a roster where individual cases are allotted to benches based on the category under which they fall. And by convention of the court, the important cases of public interest or sensitive matters are first heard by the Chief Justice of India, and if in case the CJA is not willing for some reason, it should be assigned to the next senior most judge in the Supreme Court. Instead of this, the four senior judges accuse that certain cases have been assigned to certain benches, which will eventually lead to their quiet burial. And the immediate trigger for such accusation is regarding the assignment of a petition seeking an independent probe into the mysterious death of a CBI judge who was hearing the Sohrabuddin Sheikh encounter case, where initially the BJP president was an accused but later discharged. Given the political sensitivity of the matter, the questions raised by the senior judges over the integrity of the judicial system will have wide-ranging consequences with regards to its credibility. In this regard, the government has already said that it is an internal conflict of the judiciary and has decided to stay away from it. And the apex court would do well not to brush away the concerns of these judges, but to convene a meeting of the full court and give them a complete hearing into the concerns raised. Because any internal rift in the judiciary poses a serious risk to the esteem it enjoys in the society, thereby demanding a collective introspection by the institution. With that, let's move on to the next issue in news, which is regarding geographical indication tag. And it is in news because recently Odisha has sought for GI tag for the Kandamal turmeric grown in the region, which is known for its medicinal value as well as for its sustainability in adverse climatic conditions. UPSC in the past has asked various questions on the geographical indications and the products which are awarded geographical indications, therefore making it very important to us from the examination point of view. In this regard, a GI tag is a sign used on products that have a specific geographical origin and possess qualities that are due to that geographical origin. Please have a rough idea on the GI tags awarded to different products. The next issue in news is regarding the recent launch by ISRO of 31 satellites into space, which is special for many reasons, like its payload at two Indian satellites, namely a micro satellite and a nano satellite, showing India's technological prowess towards miniaturization of satellites. Another standout of this launch is its primary payload itself, which is an advanced remote sensing CartoSat series satellite. The CartoSat 2 image sensing satellite will be used to develop land and geographical information system applications and has a design life of 5 years. With that, let's move on to the next issue in news. The next issue in news is regarding the recent demands made by India to UK to review its immigration policies relating to India. India and UK have already agreed to the terms of a memorandum of understanding on the swift return of Indian illegal immigrants from the UK. And the current development pertains to the issues raised by the Indian government regarding the visa policies of UK, like the two-year visa system available for business travelers, for Chinese visitors, but not to Indians, the issues relating to the student visa, as well as treatment of women on spousal visa, and finally, it also raised the need for visa-free travel for Indian diplomats in the UK, as Britain remained the only major European country not to bring in this policy. The final issue in news today is regarding the rising levels of inflation measured by the Consumer Price Index on account of rise in the food, fuel and housing costs, which has led to various economists observing that the Reserve Bank of India may retain its cautionary monetary stance. Please go back and do some research on the various terminologies in this news article, like Consumer Price Index, inflation, monetary policy, etc. With that, I wrap up today's news analysis. Do like, share and comment to support this initiative. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.